Welcome back to Rice-Eccles Stadium for game two of our 5A semifinals. The Bingham Miners undefeated, dressed in all blue, taking on the Fremont Silverwolves. Silverwolves coming in with one loss. They're dressed in white, trimmed in blue. The winner of this game will meet the Lone Peak Knights in the 5A title game next week. Lone Peak earlier defeated American Fork 66-19. Fremont on the opening kick. They'll have it first and 10 at their own 20-yard line to get things started. For the Silverwolves, they're led by their senior quarterback, Saxton Morby, 6 foot, 170-pounder. They're coached by Corey Boskeeter. Miners coached by John Lamborn. Austin Freeman, keep your eye on him, number 29 for the Fremont Silverwolves. He is Mr. Everything. Three touchdowns a week ago in the win over Taylorsville in the quarterfinals. So we're underway here. The second 5A semis. Fremont, first and 10. Morby to Hayes Hadley. He's the go-to guy on the receiving core. 5-yard pickup, second down and 5 coming up. I'll give him 6 on that pass play, so second down and 4 coming up. Hadley on the end around, and Hayes Hadley close to the first down marker, right at the 30-yard line. They are going to give it to him. So gain of 4. One more game after this, Desert Hills and Stansbury at 6:30, 3AA semis here in Rice-Eccles. So first and 10 at the 30-yard line. Here comes the pressure, the dump off to Austin Freeman, and Freeman is thrown out of bounds at the 36-yard line. Daniel Oua on the tackle for the Miners. Morby, going to be about 2 yards shy of the first down, picked up a couple. Third and 2 coming up, 38-yard line. Fremont's only loss coming at Roy this year. Third and 2. Austin Freeman, he's got the first down across the 42 out to the 43-yard line. Move the chains again for the Silverwolves, and Bingham's defense, one of the toughest in the state. And right now, Fremont's been able to move it, mainly on the ground. 43-yard line, first and 10, Freeman behind Morby. And we got a flag. False start on Fremont. Big thanks to K-Jazz, our partner in the semifinals and the championship games, for their partnership in our production. So you might be watching this on Facebook Live on the Deseret News Facebook page. If you are, hope you're enjoying that. Ball spotted back at the 38, first and 15. Austin Freeman's first carry, and it's a big one. Austin Freeman got the edge. He's got the first down in Bingham territory, knocked out at the 38-yard line. 24-yard run, Austin Freeman. Had a couple of long runs. They love that little misdirection counterplay off the right tackle. He had a couple of runs over 50 yards for touchdowns against Taylorsville with that exact same play last week. Longi Tuifua with the tackle. 2-yard pickup, second down and 8 coming up for the Silver Wolf. Opening drive here, 5A semis, Fremont on the move. Now Morby calling the play, changing it at the line of scrimmage. Play clock down to 5. Morby. Across the middle, caught inside the 25 to the 23-yard line. 13-yard pass play. Hayes Hadley with his second reception. Plenty of protection for Morby. Four miners around Hadley, but it was perfectly executed. Austin Freeman, flag on the play, and he stopped for no gain. Lonnie Longy in on the stop for the Miners that time. There was a flag right at the snap along the line of scrimmage. So that will move it up a few yards to the 17. It'll be 1st and 5 from there for the Miners. So great start for Fremont right here, trying to finish it off. You see Coach John Lamborn taking over for Dave Peck, the legendary coach of Bingham a couple years ago. Austin Freeman trying to pick his way for a couple, but that's about all he gets. Longy in on the tackle. Brigham Tuatagaloa also in on the stop. No gain on the play. Still 2nd down and 5. Bingham showing blitz. They back off the option. Morby keeps it. Bounced off Longy, but then he was taken down by a couple of Miners, including Jay Tufele. Gain of a yard, 3rd down and 4 coming up. Fremont's taken nearly 5 minutes off the clock to start this football game. And they're just trying to punch it in the end zone. Austin Freeman is the kicker. Hasn't had to kick a lot of field goals this year. So they want to punch it in. It is Freeman. Freeman busts through. Austin Freeman's got a 16-yard touchdown. Fremont on the board first. Austin Freeman, 16-yard touchdown. And now he's on to kick the extra point. Kick is up and it is no good. Oh boy, let's see how that comes back. If that's going to be a big factor. 6-0, Fremont Silver Wolves take over 7 minutes on the opening drive, and they get it in the end zone and lead the Bingham Miners 6-0 here on Game Night Live. The kick in the end zone, a touchback. So Bingham will have its first crack at it, first and 10 at their own 20-yard line, trailing 6-0. The Miners, led by quarterback Matt Dane, 5'11", 190-pound senior. Tate Peterson is one of their go-to running backs, as well as Jordan Kimball. Little room on the first play from scrimmage for the Miners, all the way out to the 42-yard line. And that is Tate Peterson, the 5'10", 200-pound senior. Or 27-yard run. Jay Scott making the stop. First and 10 at the 47-yard line. This time it's Amoni Kaili, junior, picks up 3. Second and 7 from the 45. Couple yards on that run. Daniel Loa. Coulter Wild on the tackle for the Silver Wolves. Picked up 3, third down and 4 coming up. Daniel Loa and Jordan Kimball in the backfield. It's Loa. Loa's got the first down near the 40-yard line of Fremont. They'll mark him down at the 41. That's a 7-yard run. There's the play before for Loa. First and 10 at the Fremont 41-yard line. Silver Wolves with the 7-minute and 10-second drive to open the game up and scored a touchdown. Austin Freeman, 16 yards. They lead it 6-0. Run up the middle, nice yardage, first down inside the 30. Amoni Kaili with the run. That's a 13-yard pickup. Carried a couple of Silver Wolves along for the ride. First and 10, 28-yard line. Kaili and Kimball in the backfield. Matt Dane's going to keep it on the quarterback draw sneak, and he'll pick up 5 yards, make it 6 yards, second down and 4. Second down and 4 coming up. Jackson Peterson on the tackle for Fremont. Kimball and Loa behind Dane in the I formation. Loa's got it. And Loa inside the 10, another first down at the 8-yard line, 14-yard run. So the running game picking up big chunks of yardage at a time. And the Miners getting close now. Daniel Loa just following a wall of blockers. Have a sea of blue in front of him. And he wasn't touched until he was 12, 13 yards down the field. First and goal at the 8-yard line. Matt Dane on the keeper inside the 5 to the 4. Chaden Dayton on the tackle. Kaili and Kimball behind Dane. Kaili fights his way in for the 5-yard touchdown. Amoni Kaili. And the Miners have tied it up with the extra point on tap. Right there, Kaili just picking his way and find a little gap, and then by the time he was met by a Fremont defender, he was on the 1-yard line and powered his way in. We have an injured Silver Wolf down at the 9-yard line. That might be Colter Wild. Boy, and that would be a big blow if he's not able to remain in the game and if it's anything serious, which I hope it's not, because he is their defensive stud. We'll take a break on Game Night Live. Colter Wild was able to walk off under his own power. Hopefully he'll be able to get back in. Extra point coming up for the Miners. It is up and it is good. So the Bingham Miners take a 7-6 lead. 2 touchdowns on the opening drives for both teams. 7-6 Bingham over Fremont here on Game Night Live. The Hadley boys back to receive this kick. Hayes number 5 and Cade number 15. And they won't get a chance to return it as it is going to be a touchback. So Fremont will have it for the second time. They drove 80 yards. Austin Freeman capping it off with a 16-yard touchdown. And then Bingham getting it and driving 80 yards. A 4-yard touchdown from Amoni Kaili. But Fremont missed the extra point. Bingham made it, so it's a 7-6 golf ball game. Saxton Morby all by himself in the backfield. Out of the gun, here comes the pressure. Morby trying to get away and picks up maybe a yard. That's it. Lika Ata'ata on the tackle. Number 28 for the Bingham Miners. Gain of a yard, second down and 9 coming up. Freeman picks up a couple. Third down and 6. Ball at the 24-yard line. Morby to throw. Here comes the pressure all the way into Bingham territory. What a job by Saxton Morby to elude a couple of Bingham Miners and then find number 44, Caden Williams. What a
Morby
play
to throw.
Morby. Here comes the pressure.
Eludes
one guy, eludes another one, and then he's got a wide open receiver. Finds Caden Williams. Big gain out to the 49-yard line. And here's a Austin Freeman on the swing route. And Freeman inside the 40 to the 36-yard line. Tackled by the Miners, Kai Fotu. Pickup of 8, second down and 2 coming up. What a play by Morby. Freeman's got it and doesn't get much. Tuifua on the tackle. Maybe a half a yard, that's about it. Be third down and 2 coming up. Quarterback keeper, and he's not going to get it. Morby tried to take it up the middle, then bounce outside. So that brings up 4th and 1. Coach Corey Boskeeter, looks like he's going to go for it. Why not? That is the end of the first quarter. The Bingham Miners with a 7-6 lead over the Fremont Silverwolves here on Game Night Live. We start the second quarter now. Fremont with the football, trailing Bingham 7-6. Fremont fourth down and a yard at the 35-yard line. The play action, it is no good, and it's intercepted. Now they're going to say he did not catch it, or he did. Yes, he did. I believe that was Jalen Vickers that made the interception. Ball was tipped. Ooh, Vickers taking it right off the carpet. Either way, it's Bingham football. So they hold on downs. Miners take over at their own 35-yard line, leading 7-6. Javonte Smith that time with the carry. So Bingham has three or four running backs. They like to shuffle in and out. And they can all get the job done. 9-yard pickup, second and a yard. Smith again. This time he's met right at the line of scrimmage. That's Brett Hancock. Daniel Loa for the Miners had 28 yards on three carries in that first quarter. Austin Freeman, seven carries, 51 yards, and a 19-yard touchdown run. Bingham has yet to throw a pass. Saxton Morby, 5 of 5, 66 yards in that first quarter. First and 10, 47-yard line. Tate Peterson on the carry. Picks up two. Second down and 8. First pass attempt, and it's caught for a first down, 42-yard line. Ryan Wood. That's a first down. Ball at the 42-yard line of Fremont. Peterson in the backfield, but it's a quick handoff to Kaili, and he's down at the 35. Pick up a 5, second down and 3 coming up. Kaili in the backfield behind Dane. The handoff to Kaili. It is a handoff to Kaili. And he is smothered at the line of scrimmage. Nice play fake on Dane. Jay Scott on the tackle for the Silver Wolves. Third and 2 coming up for Bingham. Loa's got it, and Daniel Loa's got a first down, and he is ripped down at the 29-yard line. Nigel Dalton with the tackle. But it's a first down for the Miners at the Fremont 28. Gain of three. Peterson on the carry. Dalton and Heston Hobbs both on the tackle. Gain of four, second down and six coming up. Peterson, not much there that time. Dakota Thompson on the tackle for Fremont. They'll give him a yard. Third and five coming up for the Miners, leading Fremont 7-6. Just over seven left here in the first half. Kaili flanked to the right of Dane. Dane's going to throw quickly out in the flat off the fingertips of his receiver. He would have been a yard shy of the first down anyway. Braden Cosper is the receiver. Nice coverage by the Fremont Silverwolves' Hayes Hadley. So fourth down and five. Bingham does have a good kicker, Cade Lever. Should be about a 39-yard field goal, but they're going to go for it. Fourth down and five. Loa in the backfield. Fake to Loa. Dane's going to throw. Now he's going to run. Matt Dane's not going to make it. Knocked out of bounds, short of the first down. Needed to get to the 18. He was knocked out at the 22. So a good defensive stand by Fremont to get the ball back on downs. That's a good sign right there. Coulter Wild back in, the defensive end and tight end after being shaken up earlier in the first quarter. First and 10 at the 22-yard line. Freeman's got it, and Austin Freeman out across the 25 to the 27-yard line. It'll be second down and five. Shadow starting to creep over Rice Eccles now. Morby to throw. Here comes the pressure. It's caught. Hadley's got it. Going to be close to a first down. Going to be about a yard shy, though. Third down and one coming up. Right there. Here comes the pressure. And Morby just dumped it off in time. And Hadley was there. It's going to be about a yard shy of the first down. Third and one. Freeman behind Morby. Austin Freeman hit behind the line of scrimmage, and then he fights his way and needed to get to the 32. And one official has him right at the 32, and that's going to be close. They might have to measure this one, but according to where the marker is at the 32, well, they're about the same. They're going to have to measure this. It's going to be close. But Freeman did a nice job just to get back to the line of scrimmage with a chance to pick up the first down as he was hit in the backfield. This is going to be close. It is a first down by the nose of a football. First and 10, 32-yard line of Fremont, 5:52 remaining here, first half. Fremont trailing Bingham 7-6 on a missed extra point. Here comes the pressure. Morby to Hadley. Hayes Hadley up to the 45-yard line. There's a flag. But they brought an all-out blitz that time, and Morby running for dear life got it away to Hadley. Be a 13-yard pickup if it counts. Yeah, roughing the passer on Bingham. Let's see this one again. You see, here comes the pressure. I don't know. Come on, they're both running towards each other. I believe it's because he put out his hands, but I mean, it wasn't a hit. It was a little nudge. I don't know. Gotta let him play. That wasn't anything vicious, and really that much late either. So they call it on Lalani Longhi. So first and 10, the 37-yard line of Bingham. Over the middle to Hadley, over the top of his head. Tanner Merrill was the guy in coverage. Second down and 10 at the 37. Morby, pass batted down by Longhi. So third and 10 coming up. Austin Freeman once again flanked to the left of Morby. Third and 10 at 37-yard line. Morby, here comes a pressure again. Saxton Morby over the head of his intended receiver. Good pressure, good coverage. Jackson Bolos, the intended receiver, Jalen Vickers on the coverage. So now it's fourth and 10. Morby's going to have to punt away now. Nobody back for Bingham. Either they don't believe this is going to be a punt or it's going to be a pooch kick anyway, and there wouldn't be any need for a return. And Fremont's going to take a delay of game to move it back a little bit. Move it back to the 42. A little more room to kick. Now they got somebody back. It's Daniel Loa. Oh, and he can take a fair catch at the 2-yard line. Wow. I don't think Coach Lamborn wanted him to take that fair catch at the 2. So that's where the Miners will take over. Timeout. 5:04 left. Miners on top of Fremont, 7-6. First and 10 at the 2-yard line for the Miners. Got a little breathing room on that play. All the way out to the 13-yard line. Kaili with the run. It's an 11-yard run to get him out from their own goal line. Peterson, he's brought down from behind. Nice job by Fremont's Heston Hobbs coming over from the backside and taking Peterson down just as he was starting to get momentum. 3-yard pickup, 2nd down and 7. Loa now in the backfield. And Dane's going to call a timeout. 4:07 left, first half. Miners on top of Fremont, 7-6 here on Game Night Live. Second down and 6 for the Miners. And Loa going to get the first down out at the 27. Fremont looked to have him bottled up, but then he just kind of stumbled his way through for an extra 3 or 4 or 5 yards, and that's what picks up the first down. Ball at the 27-yard line, 1st and 10. And flag movement, Bingham. Ball spotted back at the 22. First and 15. Peterson. And Peterson brought down from behind. Nigel Dalton dragging him down. Second and 11. Pass complete. First down. Knocked out beyond the 40-yard line. Braden Cosper with the reception. Just a little quick hitter out in the flat. Cosper turn. Nobody within 5-6 yards, and he picks up a first down. 43-yard line. Daniel Loa this time. And Loa is tripped up. Brett Hancock tripped him up, but still 6-yard gain from Daniel Loa. Right there, Hancock just got a hand on the ankle of Loa. Second down and 4, ball just shy of midfield. Kaili and Loa behind Dane. Kaili, first down, 45-yard line. Jay Scott on the tackle. Timeout Fremont, 1:55 left here in the first half. Bingham still leading. Fremont 7-6 here on Game Night Live. First and 10 at the 45-yard line for the Miners, leading Fremont 7-6. Kaili's got it. Kaili's got some room inside the 30 to the 25-yard line. That's a 20-yard run. Amoni Kaili. Looks like he was just waiting for a spot to open up, just kind of like, where is it at? Where is it? There it is. 20-yard gain by Amoni Kaili. Clock running, 1:40 left here in the first half. Bingham with a football and a 1-point lead. Kaili again at the 19. Kate Hadley, Dayton Blodnick. Jake Douglas on the stop as well. Six-yard run, second down and 4. Loa this time. Daniel Loa headed to the goal line. Daniel Loa has a 19-yard touchdown. Miners methodically moving down the field here at the end of the first half, and they get it in the end zone with 55 seconds left. Extra point is up and good. 55 seconds remaining. 14-6 Miners over Fremont here on Game Night Live. Cade Hadley back to return this kick. It's taken by Hayes Hadley at the goal line. Hadley's got some room. Hayes Hadley got the kicker to beat. And now he's trying to get to the 40-yard line, and he does with 44 seconds left. Hayes Hadley, 60-yard return. And now Fremont's got something going with time left on the clock. That was close to being a touchback, but Hadley just found a little gap, and then nice job by Lever, the kicker, to slow him down and let his teammates come and save a touchdown. So now let's see if Fremont can capitalize on it. Boy, this would be huge after going down 14-6 and a big kick return. Saxton Morby. He's going to throw, caught inside the 30, 28-yard line. A 9-yard pickup, 11-yard pickup, and that's a first down. Clock will stop for a moment as they move the chains. Fremont has two timeouts remaining. Clock now running, 36 and counting. Freeman in the backfield with Morby. Morby going to run it. Saxton Morby down to the 21-yard line. That's a 7-yard run, and Fremont may have to call a timeout with 25 seconds left, and they do. So, things just got interesting now. 25 seconds left, first half. Bingham, 14. Fremont, 6. But the Silverwolves with a chance here to get on the board. The end of the first half on Game Night Live. Second down and 3 at the 21-yard line for the Silverwolves. 25 seconds left in the first half. Morby, he's got a man. Incomplete. Little bit late on the throw. Hayes Hadley was open, but he couldn't get to him in time. Third and 3 with 21 seconds left. Third and 3. Fremont with one timeout remaining. Morby caught. First down, 15-yard line. Jackson Bolos. Hurry up offense now. Clock hasn't started as they move the chains. And now Fremont calls a timeout. I don't think they wanted to call a timeout. And that is Fremont's final timeout with 17 seconds left. 14-6, Bingham over Fremont here on Game Night Live. Seconds left. Fremont trailing Bingham 14-6 here in the first half. First and 10 from their own 15, from Bingham's 15-yard line. Morby fakes to Freeman. Morby. Now he dumps it off. Inside the 10-yard line. Now they've got to hurry. Ball down at the 9. They're going to have to spike this. 5, 4, 3, 2. And they do spike it with 1 second left. Nice work since they couldn't get it out of bounds. They got one tick left. You try to kick a field goal, which they missed an extra point in the first quarter with Austin Freeman, or do you try to go for it? I think Boskeeter's going to go for it. He doesn't want to mess around with his kicking game. There you see Morby. They were trying to get it down the sideline on that little wheel route, but that was covered. And then Hadley had no other place to go other than inside. That was a great defensive job by the Bingham Miners to keep him from going out of bounds. So 1 second left. We'll be back to see how it ends here in the first half on Game Night Live. So here we go, barring a defensive penalty. Final play of the first half, 1 second left. Fremont down 14-6, third and 3. Morby with Freeman, flanked to his right. Saxton Morby. Uh-oh, nowhere to go. He's got to get rid of it. To the end zone, incomplete. Incomplete. Fremont wants a pass interference call. They're not going to get it. So we have come to the end of the first half. The Bingham Miners leading the Fremont Silverwolves 14-6 here on Game Night Live. We'll be back with the second half in 15 minutes, and that could have been a pass interference, but it was not called. See you in 15 minutes.
And yeah. Oh, that's mine right there. Yeah, we're ready. And welcome back into the Deseret News Rewind halftime show. Dusty Litster and Dane Stewart. And Dane, we set up everything on Facebook Live. Okay, a couple things that didn't happen that we thought, that happened that we didn't think would happen. Number one, Fremont changed their offense. They come out running a spread offense, and I tell you what, good on them.
Yeah.
I mean, you come out, and that's the way you're going to be able to go after Bingham, is spread them out and then attack them.
Yeah, and it's no secret. You look at the teams that have had success against Bingham, it's Lone Peak, it's Jordan, it's teams that are going to 3, 4, 5 receiver sets, and it's not something that we're accustomed to seeing from Fremont. But they've done it, and they've done a really nice job of it. Morby has looked comfortable in it. Some of the snaps have been a little high, maybe a little juggly, but you can tell some of that's just unfamiliarity. But they've done a really good job executing this offense in the first half.
You know, the question is, that if it's you and you're down there and you're able to spike with 1 second left, you taking points or are you going for a touchdown?
Yeah, you know, I don't mind going for the touchdown. I think the traditional mindset is to take the field goal, right, to get points. And I mean, you're still within one possession. You're down by 8, but Bingham does get the ball coming out of halftime. You know, there are some questions around maybe the field goal capability of Fremont. You think back to the PG game, had a missed PAT in this first half. And so it's not a team that is comfortable, that has a lot of experience going for field goal goals this season. But some question marks there. And you have to remember, one of their field goal kickers is Austin Freeman, their running back. And so, I mean, is there maybe some hesitancy around putting him back there to kick around a team aggressive like Bingham? And so, I mean, I don't maybe mind it quite so much, but it's a big call. Could weigh into the outcome.
You look in the first half, when you look at Fremont, we talk about how impressed we are because really didn't know how well they were going to move the ball against Bingham, and I love what they were able to do offensively. Saxon Moresby, 10 of 17. He's going to have to throw the football, 110 yards, so he's halfway to the over-under I gave him. I gave him an over-under of 225. He watched our pregame show. And then Austin Freeman running the ball a lot better, and I think that is because they're spreading him out, 9 carries, 57 yards. Now let's take a look at the Bingham Miners. They're going to get done with a crew of guys. And the over-under was 5 running backs.
Yep.
5 guys in the running category. You got 4 in the first half. But you have 4 guys with over 30 yards in the game. Khalili with 97 or 71 yards. And then Daniel Loa with 70 yards rushing in the first half.
Yeah, it's been successful. I was going to try to think of a fancy way to put that, but it's been a really good half for Bingham. 200 yards rushing as a team, Dusty, on 27 carries. So you look at that, I mean, man, they are getting big chunks just running that football down the throat of Fremont. And that was one of the concerns for me, was how is the Fremont front 7 going to do against this very physical Bingham offensive line, where they've been pushed back time after time after time. They're going to have to find an answer in the second half.
Now, if you are unimpressed with the Bingham Miners and what they did in the first half, I think maybe it leaves them subject to losing this ballgame, then you have not followed Bingham in the state tournament. They had a very tough first half against Hunter in the first round. And then last week had a very tough first half as well, but they bounced back and blanked both those teams in the second half en route to coming to the semifinals.
They did. It was 14-3 against Hunter at halftime, and then last week 14-7 against Lehigh. So this game fitting right in the mold. And if it fits in the mold, it's bad news for Fremont because, and even at that, you know, Fremont scores on their opening drive, and what happens? Bingham makes some adjustments, right? They understand how Fremont's going to try to attack them, and that defense has been much better outside of that opening drive. They've really cut them down quite a bit, and I think you're going to see something similar in the second half. Coach Bosky, he's going to have to come out with something that is going to give Bingham a different look, because they've figured out what you're trying to do. They've adjusted to it. Morby's getting pressure. He's escaping it and doing a nice job. They're going to have to do something to make this Bingham defense uncomfortable again.
You know, and the thing is, we're talking about Fremont as though they are playing spectacular football. Now, granted, they are. They have moved the ball extremely well against Bingham when we didn't know if they would. And part of it is the spectacular plays that are made. If you even watch Saxon Morby play, I mean, we got some games you can go up on High School Rewind on YouTube and go watch some of these games. But you watch what he did. Very Carson Wentz-esque against the Pittsburgh Steelers. And some of the things he's able to do and just escape. And and he's not able to get on the outside, but Dan, as you pointed out earlier so eloquently and correctly, that he's able to do it up the middle of the pocket. He's been able to escape this pressure and extend plays and make big plays as well.
Yeah, I mean, not many quarterbacks go for positive rushing yards against Bingham, and he has 11 yards at the half. So, I mean, that's, hey, that's a victory for Fremont. But to your point, it comes back to his ability to escape, right? There's a play where it looks like he's going to get sacked. And what happens, he's able to get outside the pocket. He's able to avoid a couple guys and just, you know, gets it off, and it's a big play for Fremont. We've seen Saxton Morby do that time after time again. We talked in the pregame, Dusty. 40 total touchdowns for Saxton Morby, 27 of them throwing, 13 rushing. This is a kid that he has ran the ball all season. He is able to escape pressure out of the pocket. And you thought that might be maybe a bit of an equalizer for the Fremont Silverwolves. It's what's kept them in this game in the first half.
You know, on Deseret News Rewind, every week we put out videos you can find on DeseretNews.com. But what we talked about last week were turning points in every game.
Yeah.
And what you're looking here at the beginning of the first or the second half, pardon me, is Bingham's getting the football. But what happened at the end of the first half could be an absolute turning point. Fremont gets a big return from Hayes Hadley. They get down toward the 15-yard line. They are stopped inside the five with no points. With an opportunity to get down maybe by 1 point if you get the touchdown and extra point. But now Bingham starts the second half with the football. And Fremont's having a hard time stopping this offense. This first drive is an absolute turning point in this ballgame.
You're absolutely correct. And when you think about, you know, what led up to Fremont's last drive of the first half, right? They actually got a stop. On a fourth down, Bingham goes for it. They get the big stop. They get the ball back, and they start heading down the field. Going to have a similar response from the defense on this first drive. I'm with you, right? If Bingham gets points on this drive and they make it a two-possession game, it's going to start snowing here at Rice Eccles, right? That avalanche of Bingham just overpowering you, almost like a boa constrictor, just constricting and taking the life out of you. The defense has to show up on this drive coming out of halftime. It's going to be huge for Fremont.
What do you see happening in the second half? And who's heading to the championship game to take on Lone Peak?
Yeah, I think whenever you have 200 yards rushing in a half, that's a good sign, right? I think you're going to continue to see Bingham continue to power the football and maybe even see them open up some play action. We've seen them try it a couple times, though Dane's only throw the ball for three times. I wouldn't be surprised to see them.
I don't think they put the ball here unless they have to.
But there's no need to when you're averaging 8.5 yards a carry. I think Bingham right now offensively, they're getting what they want. And they don't care if they win this game 24-7 or if they win it 48-7, right? A win is a win, and you're on to the championship. I think Bingham is in pretty good shape.
Yeah, it's going to be very interesting. Big second half coming up. Big first drive of the second half for Fremont. I expect this offense to, I think you see some trick plays get going. They're going to try and find some other ways because if they're down 21-6, it's time to start opening things up even more than you already were, because if you don't, Bingham's not giving you the ball back, a chance to come back and do it.
Well, and I think even if you're down, you know, 14-6, right, you might start seeing some trick plays because you got to do something to ignite that team. Fremont has not been able to get consistent drives as of, you know, their first drive in the game.
Absolutely. Well, this is the Deseret News Rewind Halftime Show. Dusty Lister and Dane Stewart. Again, we're going to have all kinds of Deseret News Rewind videos throughout the week. I also have interviews from each of these games. You can go on DeseretNews.com afterward. We'll have them up shortly after each game, so you can go watch each of the interviews from these teams. And also highlights, also recapping the semifinals today and tomorrow. We're going to be with you Facebook Live tomorrow as well, pregame shows for each of the 4A games. Again, for Dane Stewart, I'm Dusty Lister. This has been the Deseret News Rewind Halftime Show. Rod Zundel coming back on the other side as you get a chance to watch your home of the 5A state tournament here on DeseretNews.com. What a bad.
We are set to begin the second half here in Rice-Eccles Stadium. And it is a touchback, so the Miners will take over to begin the third quarter. First and 10 at their own 20-yard line. Bingham leading Fremont 14-6. The winner of this game will take on Lone Peak for the 5A championship next week. Lone Peak defeated American Fork earlier today. For the Miners, Amoni Ely, 9 carries, 71 yards. Daniel Loa, 7 carries, 70 yards. Matt Dane, 2 of 3, 25 yards. For the Silver Wolves, Austin Freeman leading the way on the ground, 9 carries, 57 yards. Saxon Morby, 10 for 17, 110 yards. And quickly, that's Peterson with a big run on first down out across the 50-yard line down to the 48. Tate Peterson, 32-yard run on the first play from scrimmage in the third quarter. Basically just a simple dive off the right tackle, and he wasn't touched until he was about 30 yards downfield. First and 10 at the Fremont 48-yard line. Trying the left side this time, and that's going to be close to another first down. That's Kaili that time. It'll be a yard shy of the first down, second down and one at the 39-yard line of Fremont. Daniel Loa got the first down, 36-yard line, gain of 3. Miners first down, leading 14-6. Kaili behind Dane. The handoff to Kaili, and he's met, but then falls forward. Brett Hancock, the first to hit him, but couldn't wrap him up, and he'll pick up 4. It'll be second down and 6. Silver will scored on their first drive, an 80-yard drive, 6-0. Austin Freeman, 16-yard touchdown, missed the extra point. Bingham comes right back on its first drive. Amoni Kaili, 4-yard touchdown run, extra point good, takes 7-6 lead. Then the final minute, Daniel Loa, 19-yard touchdown run to give Bingham a 14-6 lead. That's where we stand right now. 2 minutes gone by here in the third quarter. Third and a yard. Ball at the 27 of Fremont. Kaili and Kimball behind Dane in the I formation. Kaili's got it. He's got the first down across the 25 down to the 24. Jackson Peterson on the tackle for the Silver Wolves. There's the coach, Corey Boskeeter, for the Silver Wolves. Defense trying to stop Bingham here, keep it a one-possession ball game. Miners pretty close to field goal range. Right now it would be a 41-yarder. Lever can kick it. Kaili. Brett Hancock brings him down. He'll pick up 4. Second down and 6. Kaili again off the right side. Big room this time. Amoni Kaili inside the 10, down to the 6-yard line. That's a 14-yard run. It's first and goal, Miners. First and goal from the 6. Dane on the keeper. Still on his feet. Matt Dane to the 2. Second and goal. They'll mark it down just inside the 2. Kaili in for the 1-yard touchdown. Moni Kaili now makes this a 2-score game. Lever on for the extra point. It is good. 8:01 left. Bingham 21, Fremont 6 here on Game Night Live. Hayes Hadley and Kate Hadley back to return this kick. And it will be Hayes Hadley. Returned a big one at the end of the first half, but not this time. Doesn't get back to the 20. So now the Fremont Silver Wolves down 21-6. We'll have it first and 10 at their own 18-yard line. Morby, here comes the pressure. And it's caught by Hayes Hadley out at the 32-yard line. What a play. First and 10, 32-yard line. Austin Freeman picks up a couple, that's it. Freeman again. Austin Freeman's got a little room. He's got a first down out near midfield. 17-yard run by Austin Freeman in Bingham territory at the 49. Right there. They love that play. Little misdirection off the right tackle. And timeout, Bingham, 7 minutes left, third quarter, 21-6. Miners over the Silver Wolves here on Game Night Live. First and 10 at the 49-yard line of Bingham. Fremont with the ball, trailing 21-6. Austin Freeman nowhere to go and going to lose a couple of yards and a flag on the play. Holding on Fremont. First and 22 at the 39. Morby. Caught. Or was he out of bounds? No, he's out of bounds. Nice attempt, though, by Jackson Bullis. So it'll be second down and 22. Right there. Ooh. Ooh, that looked close. Second down, 22. Morby. Across the middle just a little bit. Too much in front of Hadley. Couldn't hang on. Third and 22 at the 39. Morby on the quarterback draw. Saxton Morby trying to get to the first down. He's going to be close. He dives to the marker. I think he's going to have it, or he's going to be close. Depending on the spot. Let's see if they give him the right spot. I don't know if they did. Needed 22. First down. What a job by Saxton Morby. They put Austin Freeman in motion like they're going to throw a screen out to him. And then Morby just went up the middle and then veered off left and picked up 22 yards on third and 22. Boy, Morby's come up with some great second efforts today. Here comes a pressure. Flag on the play. Morby. Couple of receivers down there, but couldn't make the connection. We'll see what the flag is. Another holding call on Fremont. So that'll be moved back from the spot. First and 22 back at the 49-yard line for the Silver Wolves. The screen to Freeman, and he loses the football, and there's a scramble for it, and the Miners have come away with it, I do believe. They're still trying to sort out the pile, and I think Fremont is going to lose it. It's Bingham football. Austin Freeman hit and fumbles. Let's see who made the hit. 38, Cole Moody. And knocked it loose. Loa fell on the football. So the Miners will have it at the 45 of Fremont. Kaili picks up four. Second and six, 41-yard line. That's a first down run by Kaili. 32-yard line. 9-yard run. Daniel Loa this time. Brought down at the 27. 5 yard gain, second and five coming up. Heston Hobbs on the tackle. Tell you, critical possession here for the Fremont defense. If they let Bingham score here, it will be tough to come back. Tate Peterson. Going to be about a yard shy of the first down. Third and a yard for the Miners, leading 21-6, maybe putting the game away right here. Dane's got the first down. Brought down just shy of the 20. First and 10, 21-yard line. Kaili on the quick hitter to the 15-yard line. Noah Stinger and Ben Erickson on the stop. Or excuse me, that's Cooper Sipers on the stop as well. But we do have a flag. Personal foul on Bingham. So that will move it back to the 30. Dane to throw, and he's going to the end zone. Has a receiver, but it goes over his head. That's Braden Cosper. Jake Douglas on the coverage. Third and 19 from the 30. Loa. Daniel Loa still on his feet. Daniel Loa is in for the touchdown. Daniel Loa, 30-yard touchdown. Thought he may step out of bounds, but he did a tightrope along the sideline. We're going to have to see on replay here if he did step out of bounds. Oh, what a tightrope job right there. Daniel Loa staying in bounds, keeping his balance, 30-yard touchdown, and this game may have just been put away right there. Lever on for the extra point. It is up and good. So with 2:23 left, Daniel Loa, 30-yard touchdown. Now the Bingham Miners comfortably out in front, 28-6. Trying to get to the 5A title game to take on Lone Peak next week here on Game Night Live. The Hadleys back. Receive this kick from Lieber. And that's going to be a touchback. So if Fremont wants to get back into this game, they got to do it in a hurry. With 2:23 left here in the third down, 28-6. Morby, caught, Hayes Hadley, near midfield. Going to be a 30-yard connection. Nice touch on the ball to allow Hadley to run under it and keep his feet. First and 10 right at midfield. Freeman hit just as soon as he got the handoff, and I believe making the first contact was Kai Fotu. That kind of just disrupted that entire play. Five-yard connection, Hadley. Third and 5 coming up. Freeman got a first down to the 38-yard line. Caught. 29-yard line, going to be about a yard shy of the first down. Morby trying to elude the pressure again. This time he can't pull off the magic. Going to lose a couple. Bring up 3rd and 4. And that is the end of the third quarter. The Bingham Miners on top of the Fremont Silverwolves, 28-6, here on Game Night Live. Start the fourth quarter, third and four. Morby's going to run for it. He's got the first down. Saxton Morby out at the 20-yard line. That's a 12-yard pickup. First and 10 at the 20-yard line. Silver Wolves. Morby again. Caught, incomplete. Nice defensive play there by Tongi Longi to get back into position. Second down and 10 at the 20. Morby, here comes the pressure again, and he has to unload it before he was taken down. Third and 10 coming up. Third and 10, Morby out of the gun again. Here comes the pressure, unloads, touchdown! Hayes Hadley from Saxton Morby, 20 yards. Still a little life for the Fremont Silver Wolves. Boy, Morby just running for his life in that backfield and taking a lot of punishment, but hanging in there. Timeout, Bingham, 11:32 left, 28-12. Miners still hanging on to the lead. Two-point conversion, Hayes Hadley out of the Wildcat, and he goes nowhere. Well stuffed by the Bingham Miners, Kai Fotu was the guy who got there, and also Longy. So with 11:32 left, it remains 28 Bingham, 12. Well, Fremont here on Game Night Live. Bingham expecting the onside kick, but they're not going to get it. That's Loa with it at the 12. And Daniel Loa out near the 30-yard line. And his helmet comes off. Matt Wyatt Tuckett on the stop. So now with 11:26, Bingham, you'd assume, trying to run as much time off the clock as they can. Still moving down the field. E.J. Huber on the carry that time. Or excuse me, that was Javonte Smith on the carry. Second down and 6. Peterson picks up a couple. So it's going to be third down and 3 coming up. Dane to throw, but flag on the play. And it's going to be movement on Bingham. We'll move it back from 3rd and 4 to 3rd and 9. Third and 9, 31-yard line. Peterson gets to the 36. Going to be about 4 yards short of the first down. Fourth and 4. And now Fremont taking a timeout. 9:23 left. Bingham 28. Fremont 12 here on Game Night Live. Bingham just trying to lure Fremont into using one of the timeouts they have. And it's a short kick, and it will be downed at the 42-yard line. That's a 6-yard net kick. So a break for Fremont now. They're down 28-12, a touchdown and 2-point conversion. They're one score away. So they still got some life coming up. Hayes Hadley picks up a couple. Second down and 8. Ball at the 40-yard line. That's Hadley in motion. Morby. Freeman. Austin Freeman's got a first down. Austin Freeman out at the 22-yard line. That's an 18-yard pass play on the little screen. Tough to bring Freeman down in the open field, especially against a linebacker. First and 10, ball at the 21-yard line of Bingham. Fremont trying to get back into this thing and stay alive. Bingham showing blitz. Here they come. Morby hit as he throws, and it's out of bounds, intended for Hayes Hadley. His arm was bumped just as he threw it, and he couldn't get much on it. Second and 10 at the 21. Now, if we go back to the final seconds of that first half, Fremont had it first and 10 inside the 20, and they couldn't punch it in. Ran out of time. Could be a whole different ball game right now. Freeman in motion. Morby through the hands of Hadley. That was a great call on that blitz. Coming from the left side, so Hadley just went where the linebackers vacated, but they couldn't make the connection. That could have been a 6-point play right there. Third and 10. And everybody moved, but the center didn't snap the football. So now it's third and 15 at the 26-yard line. Morby tried to get it and beat the blitz to Freeman, but Freeman wasn't looking. So now it's fourth and 15. You got to go for it. Can't kick a field goal. No reason to punt this deep into Bingham territory. So Morby's got the play, and here we go. Only good thing about the last few plays is it's only taken about 10 seconds off the clock. Here comes the blitz. Morby Here comes the pressure. Morby goes down back at the 42-yard line. That's a 16-yard loss. And Fremont turns it over on downs. Any life that the Silver Wolves may have had may have just been extinguished right there. Extinguished. Tua Tagovailoa with a stop. Did I say distinguished? What a joker. Five-yard gain. Ryan Wood on the carry. Daniel Loa, first down. Now he's going to try to stay inbounds, and he does. And that's a first down at the 29-yard line of Fremont. First and 10, 29-yard line. Wood with the carry. Ryan Wood is close to another first down. He's got it. Pickup of 11. Jackson Bolos on the tackle. Ely. Nigel Dalton on the tackle for Fremont. Clock continuing to run. Under 7 minutes to play. Fourth quarter, 28 Bingham, 12 Fremont. Out to Daniel Loa. Daniel Loa's got a touchdown, 15-yard reception from Matt Dane. And that'll do it. Nice block by the receivers downfield. Braden Cosper and Dax Milne. And that allowed Daniel Loa to take it in for the touchdown. Extra point is up, and it is good. 35-12, Bingham over Fremont here on Game Night Live. Cade and Hayes Hadley back to receive the kick. And Bingham will have it first and 10 again at their, Fremont will have it first and 10 again at their own 20-yard line. Trailing now 35-12. Just a reminder, coming up, 6:30, the 3AA semifinal. Desert Hills and Stansbury, Pine View and Juan Diego play tomorrow. First and 10, Fremont now trailing 35-12 at their own 20-yard line. Morby wants to go to Hadley. Tries to haul it in with the left hand, but it falls incomplete. Caught and hit immediately and dropped. 7-yard gain, Hayes Hadley there. Tongi Longi making the stop. And Cosper is there as well. Boy, Hadley's had a workout today. Morby didn't get the first down. It's going to bring up fourth down and 2. Might as well go for it. Smote Pepa on the tackle. So fourth and 2, just over 5 minutes and counting remaining here in the fourth quarter. Fremont and Lone Peak next week in the Bingham and Lone Peak next week in the 5A title game. Bingham beat Lone Peak earlier in the season. Morby's got a first down across the 31 to the 32. Morby again trying to get away from pressure, and he does. Incomplete to Hadley. Morby and Hadley are going to be some tired individuals tonight. Second down and 10. Incomplete. Trying to get it to Tage Nielsen. Clock stop. 4:19 left. Third and 10 coming up. Third and 10. Morby again. He goes down again. This time, Longy Tuifua finishes him off. All the way back to the 14-yard line, 18-yard loss. Morby really had no chance. It's fourth and 29. Now you punt it away. Loa back to receive the kick. Right around his 40-yard line. It's a line drive right to Loa, and he hauls it in at the 36-yard line. So Bingham will have it first and 10 with 3:29 left when we come back here on Game Night Live. Ryan Wood. Picks up six. Clock continuing to run. Fremont does have two timeouts left, but I doubt Corey Boskater will use them. Again, the keep. Dylan Gibson. Just trying to run out this clock. It'll be third and four. 2.5 left to play. Incomplete, and that stops the clock. It's not what you wanted to do. It's fourth down and four. And delay a game. Ryan Wood, and he's sacked. No, he's not. Now he's sacked. Heston Hobbs and Jordan Dixon making the stop. So the ball turned over on downs with 1:56 left here in the fourth quarter. Fremont will have it. See if they can put some more points on the board before we have to get out of here. Morby, incomplete. Stops the clock. Second down and 10. Austin Freeman. So the championship game, 5A, all set for next week. Bingham and Lone Peak. It's Friday here at Ricycle Stadium. Of course, we'll have that for you here on KSL.com, DeseretNews.com, Deseret News Facebook page. And who knows? Maybe we'll hit something else next week. Hayes Hadley got a first down. So with a 1:03 left, first down for the Silver Wolves. Going deep, and it's incomplete. Intended for Hayes Hadley. Lone Peak beat American Fork earlier in the first day, 5A semi of the day. 66-19. Lone Peak can put up some points, but Bingham was able to control them a little bit in that earlier meeting. Morby, plenty of time this time. And I believe they were going to try the old hook and ladder there. Nielsen was going to pitch it back to Jay Scott, but they didn't quite make the first reception. So third and 10 with 49 seconds left. Morby goes down again. Looks like he may have got tripped, or he tripped over a foot. So now it's fourth and 10. Tui Fua makes the tackle. Fourth down and 18. Here we go. 16 seconds left. Morby, and it's incomplete, and that'll do it. 4 seconds left, so it takes one kneel down by the Miners, and this thing is officially in the books. One kneel down will do it. And there it is. So the final in the 5A semifinal. The Bingham Miners headed back to the 5A championship game, 35-12, your final over Fremont. So that sets up next week's 5A championship game, Bingham and Lone Peak. Hope you enjoyed today's semifinals. Don't forget the Desert Hills and Stansbury 3AA semis coming up at 6:30 here on KSL.com, DeseretNews.com, and Deseret News Facebook page. Hope you enjoyed the games, everybody, and we will see you tomorrow at 11 a.m., the 4A semifinals. We've got a couple of good matchups, Springville and Alta, East and Maple Mountain. So until then, we'll see you tonight on KSL Channel 5 at 6 and 10, and then again tomorrow morning, 11 o'clock, right here on KSL.com. Good night, everybody.